Well, we talk to her then. I'm not gonna read everything again. Where's the lady? There. See what we can do here. I'm gonna go quickly through it. Not at all. Some business fire to your right. That's quite empty. Business. Don't you worry. I have a lot of things that matter. I'm trying to do the same thing we did before. But I'm looking for a group of men. She gets schizo. Hold on. I haven't told you what I'm looking for. Let's go here. We change the... Those guys don't look much like moonshiners. Rather like criminals. The woman shivers of any mention. Then do the attention so we see her. I think you do know something. Now we're back here. Speechcraft failed. And now let's do this. Jesus Christ, just tell me everything and we'll part our ways in peace. What peace are you talking about? What is this about, huh? Enough is enough. Oh, you bitch, you. The hysterical notes in the voice of the woman are getting stronger and stronger. Oh no, we're gonna end up in the same situation. Okay. Damn. Because now we're smacking her. Yep, now she's close to us again. The woman's gaze wanders around. She's looking for a person who'd like to do this awkward conversation to an end as soon as possible. The poor thing isn't suspecting that you're planning a stealthy yet brutal attack on her. No, she isn't ready for it. Do we try to throw a crushing blow now, or... Take a tight grip on the opponent's face. Offense is the best defense, and the best offense is that the ones filled with rage. Without giving it a second thought, you attack the woman. Your hands are clenched at her broad, round face. The mighty woman's eyes didn't close on instinct, so your thumb spoke right into them. As she isn't prepared for your attack, she falls to your feet, screaming and shrieking. Rubbing her bleeding eyes, she is calling for help, her voice trembling and frightened. Gusty August, oh, you see the men in the tiny settlement react to the scream of Matriarch, but they can't catch you by surprise. I won't give up without a fight. What the fuck? I can't start the battle. Now it's started, okay. I'm guessing we need to hide here. Or do we hide in the back room? We can't go there because of that lady. Burst this one down. Almost dead, what the fuck? No wonder he died quickly. Okay, and then of course he runs out. Are you fucking kidding me? So we need to load this, I need to heal him up. How are you feeling? Could be worse. How are you feeling? Okay, now we gave him a medikit. He should be fine now. I don't really want to do this battle with this lady, but... Let's see if we can go some other direction. Because here we could ask about the group of men. We could instead go number one. I have a couple of very personal questions. The woman smiles sadly. What? Maybe you'd like to know how I'm a simple... How I, a simple girl, put a spell on a real Russian... Bogard here, like my husband. Well, there isn't much of a secret, really. Not at all. Just look over there. The woman extends her arm up as if she's trying to point at something that's hidden over a fence surrounding her land. Do you see that hill all covered in those new pines? There, barely a kilometer from here, there's an old rusty water pump. It was probably installed for the forest ranger before this spring appeared here. What forest ranger? The one who used to live here before us... in this little house that we used as a foundation for this magnificent residence. So yeah, go on, take a shoulder yoke, two buckets, and go up there, and pump some water, and then come back without having spilled anything, and no sleeping and resting after. No, then comes washing up, cooking soup, washing clothes. When you learn how to do all that, then you'll find yourself a good man. It's the only way. Don't even think about it, even if in the old days men didn't marry you for your looks alone. Looks are good for the fuck and duck, as the sailors used to say, and now it's even more evident. Now you need to be workful. Yes, yes, it's a word. It's good, isn't it? Workful. I've come up with it myself, yes. The woman stares past you for a few seconds, as if trying to come back to her senses. After that, she shudders. Me, oh my, you wanted to ask something. But look at me and the babbling mouth. Tell me, darling, I'm all ears. Do you know any rumors or funny stories? The woman shrugs. Oh, darling, you're so young. You won't know and see everything, but I have nothing to offer. The rumors don't reach us here. On one hand, thank God for that. On the other, it's a shame. One thing you cannot tell by looking at me is that I've always liked gossip. Shoot some breeze, chit-chat with anyone about anything. Life gets boring without it. My son, August, he's not much of a talker, and it's better to be quiet around my husband, Kostya. He's quite grim nowadays. I only get to enjoy chatting with my little one and with don't you ever miss the good old days? But why am I even asking you that? Even if you do remember those days, your memories must be quite foggy. Mine, however, is very clear. I remember everything quite well. Not long ago, I was reminiscing about this trending Krasmonyanye before the war. They used to sell books there, and sell them in a Western capitalist way, with all kinds of promotions and discounts. Let's say you wanted to get something excited to read from them. Example, The Mysterious Land by Jules Verne, or maybe 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, or was it Leagues, not Leeds. So, like I was saying, no. The price was 2 rubles and 90 kopecks. No more, no less. However, if you purchase some propaganda nonsense together with your interesting books, like something about scientific atheism or Lenin Marx writings, the price immediately dropped to 1.5 rubles. It's almost for free, do you understand? Not just for free, they were practically paying you as long as you took their political literature. I, however, wasn't even keen on that. All these writings on Krupskaya and Sherbekev were so stale, I never bought them. And now I feel sorry that I didn't. Even the smallest piece of paper is useful for making fire, or in the outhouse, or even to use as intended, read out of boredom. We're running out of paper, darling. There's no hope for more, because you see, making paper is a complicated process. And if the paper factories perished in the past bombings, what then? Are we supposed to write on tree bark or sheepskin? Even Captain Nemo didn't sink as low as to have done it. And he was alive before Jules Verne. Interesting rumor. Tell me, darling, I'm all ears. I'd like to ask about the group of men. Can we ask someone else about those info? What happens if we ask this guy? It's clear the lady goes crazy. Could also increase speechcraft. What is our speechcraft? 57. We have 30. Do we take this to 70? That's 13. No, see. Yeah, 13. Let's increase this to 70. We could go in and check if it changes anything now that we have higher speechcraft. Where did she go? She's back here. Let's talk to her here. No, that's the old lady, the younger lady. Don't be silly. Oh, number 4, I used to think the same way, but I was stunned by your beauty. The girl looks at you with confusion and takes a few steps back. Thanks, you're quite the looker yourself. She coughs and gives you a strange glance. I can't help paying a compliment to a lovely girl. Let's become friends, what do you think? The girl giggles clearly. It seems that even if your previous actions had caused some embarrassment, it's long since passed. Please do, even though Mom and Daddy always say that all travelers are basically bandits. Okay, so I have a couple of urgent questions. Let's see if we can ask her about the three guys here. Nope, can't do that. But apparently we're friends with her now, so let's talk to this mom and see what becomes of it. Okay, don't read too much into it, but I'm looking at a group of men. Continue. And I will be grateful for your help. somewhat of compassion. Sorry, no matter what you need, no one passes through here. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, we saw this. Well, try to remember. Mostly probably they look like hardened criminals. Okay, now we try speechcraft. Success. The woman tries to say something, but suddenly lets her hands fall. The mighty lady of the house starts sobbing. With every breath she takes, her sobbing becomes louder and louder. But I can't. Don't you understand? I'm not allowed. My husband prohibits me after hearing all these questions you're here to ask. We saw this. Let's try speechcraft again. I promise to find out what happened here, mother. Please make the right choice. Give me the information I need. Failure. Okay, so now we're in this situation again. Fuck. Strength. No, she's stronger than us. The woman is very close. Take a grip on the mother's face. Poke right into them. No. Okay, now we're in the fight. I don't want to do the fight. I don't like it at all. Do we go for 80? Speechcraft. See if we manage now. We're gonna need speechcraft anyway, so... Don't read my mind. I'm going the same way like I did before. Grateful for your help. Continue. Hardened criminals. Speechcraft success. Louder and louder. Crying. And now we speechcraft again. Failure. What the fuck? How high do you actually need to fucking speak this? Okay. Attack the woman without saying. How's his HP healthy? Go here. Assuming position. Okay, she's gonna attack him. I hope he understands to walk there now. What the fuck? Check the damage on this young lady. Okay, we can't really hit her there. Holy shit! Burst the fuck out of this lady. Why can't I shoot her? Can't see the target, what the fuck? I need to go here? Okay, now we burst the fuck out of her. I even shot Fidel. How can you fucking shoot someone on the ground? That makes no sense. Like, zero. Oh, there's a bed here. I haven't even seen this bed. From up, it's hard to see it. Okay, so let's go ask this guy instead, then. Ask him about the missing people. The guy looks around in fear and quickly turns back to you. Well, what, guys? You think this is an inn or something? There's just my family here. That's it. The guys who sent me here think otherwise. Still, I'd like to see for myself. The lad shakes his head and definite no. Nobody here, just like I said. Sure, that's what. I'll tell the guys that sent me here to investigate. It's so weird because every move we do ends up in we having to kill this group, even though we're the nice guys. It makes no sense. Sure, the lad squallows nervously and goes noticeably pale. What guys? There's nobody here. Ask my mom and my dad if you want to. Nobody even visits us. Easy there, big guy. Care to answer some questions? Okay. Let's ask the husband then. I wonder if we can find some proof that they are here. If we put the interesting thing on. It's quite heavy, so. Sort by weight. Just wondering if they buried them in the food and they are like making the crops stronger. No. So it seems we need to have super high speechcraft to be able to pass this situation without angering the mom. Now's the question, do we want to do it that high? It's really weird how can these go over 100? I'm just curious what to do here, because it feels like we need to do the fight, and that just feels stupid because we're actually not here as a bandit, we're here just to ask questions. But I guess that's the situation we need to accept. But it seems like the game is so stupidly done that we need to get speechcraft up. Let's see if we can manage to do this one now without the men I'm looking for worked for Dan, that's why they came here. The woman takes a step back from you in shock. For Dan? That Dennis, which, or what's his name? So they were working for that guy from the factory, the one who bleeds us dry every year and makes us pay taxes for living in on our own land. And wait a second, what else did you say? What, that he sent them? And here I thought no one has come here, but suddenly now we're talking about them. Just tell me what you know. Okay, do we try? So yeah, Dan sent those guys over here to collect. The woman looks at you in disbelief, her hands start to tremble. Collect? Is that what it was? This is their idea to get even? Having said that, the woman steps back from you in fear. It's obvious that she knows about the three brothers you're looking for, and she has just confessed to it. Having said the words that compromise her, she closes her mouth with her hands out of context, which gesture would have looked quite funny, as if the saying a spoken word takes its flight magically came to life. Well, we have high speechcraft, so let's try that one. I promise to find out what happened here, mother. Please give me the right choice. Give me the information I need. Success. Scum, bloody scum, bastard. Dear God, they did this. The woman clenches her fists. You can feel the pure true rage. You can see images of enraged mothers of the animal kingdom rushing in front of your eyes. Lioness, tigresses, desperate she-elephants. It feels that this woman is willing to tear apart with people she is trying to tell you about it, and there is no force strong enough to stop her. These three brothers on the road to Krasmanyanye asked for a place to sleep. It was obvious, it was so obvious. So Masha went missing exactly the same night, and us, we didn't pay enough attention to our own daughter. We thought she must be spending the night at the Moonshiner Petrovich places. She did that sometimes. He is our friend and our only neighbor. Oh dear God, what really happened? If you only knew, daughter, you would never walk here alone, and you wouldn't let your loved ones wander around here as well. Continue listening in silence. The woman closes her eyes and her hands with her hands and gives out a long, loud sob. It's obvious that she doesn't hear anything around her. She just talks. She needs to get some things off her chest. They've captured my baby in the forest earlier today, robbed and murdered her. Uh-huh. Maybe even did something else. These scumbags are capable of anything. They could have... No, I can't even think about it. They've killed my oldest one, my pride and joy, my most beloved child. And oh dear God Almighty, and after all that they had the guts to come here and look for a place to sleep. And I was so angry with my husband that he didn't let the guests sleep in our shed, but instead made them sleep in a tent outside. I got a pot of soup for them and went to ask whether they want it or not. That was when they tried to sell me a pendant. They said that they got it from a merchant on the way to Krasmanyanye. They said they will give me a good price for it. The lady of the house furiously slaps her own lips as an outburst of rage. I think I know where this story is headed. Continue listening in silence. But that was my little Misha pendant, do you understand? They took it from her dead body, and tried to sell it to me, to her own mother. I didn't say anything. I don't know how I managed to keep calm at that moment. I don't know how I managed not to attack them immediately. Maybe I should have done it. They would have probably killed me too before Kostya got a chance to interfere. Maybe it would have been better that way, more peaceful, without the ever-present sorrow and guilt. But I have held it together. I went to my husband Kostya. I whispered through my lips, though my lips did not obey me, that those men had Masha's pendant. That it's evident that what they did to her. That it's because of them that she's missing. But he wasn't listening to me anymore. He understood everything. He understood it immediately. He just told me to lock up the kids and not to go outside. I have listened. My legs were giving out. I spent that hour on my knees in front of the door. I couldn't even answer my kids' questions. When we finally went outside, it was already done. Kostya took care of those three. Don't ask me how, because I don't know. Then he told us not to enter the pigsty for the next 3 days, and I've seen their damn blood spilled in the dust near the tent. When the morning came, the wind has mixed it with sand and dispersed it. But my baby girl, oh god, it hurts so much, I've talked it out. How come the pain is only getting stronger? Okay, so we have four choices. Oh, it's the most horrifying story I've ever heard. I didn't know. Please accept my condolences. The woman lets out several loud sobs and then wipes her swollen red eyes with her sarafan skirt. Anger and pain that were so present in her grim story fade into the background. The poor woman transforms again. Yes, it seems I was wrong about you after all. Or was I? Thank you, dear girl. Thank you. There aren't any words that could bring my baby back to life, of course. And I ain't gonna say that I feel even a tad better. But it's nice, you know. It's nice to know that there are kind people still left in this world. Good, unspoiled girls like you. You and my Misha would have become friends. I know it. Yes, I can see it. I can picture you together. She was... The woman smiles, but there's an incredible sadness in her eyes. She was like you, a traveler. She was always out picking mushrooms or berries, always looking for a chance to jump over the fence and run as fast as she could, my little Masha. I'm trying to read what's here. I can't believe I was sent to look for such scumbags. No one will remember them fondly, even the mobsters. That's fair. They shouldn't remember at all, if you ask me. The woman looks at you with curiosity. By the way, why were you looking for them? What could you and those damn subhumans have in common? I got involved with this gang mother. It's shameless. Is there an art? My god. Why did you even get involved with them? Run away from them, darling. Stop wandering the forest and Dale's looking for trouble. Run away. You are a young, beautiful girl. Do you really think that this is the only way? There are always a way, darling. You just need to look for it. I wish you all the happiness, darling. I wish you the true path lights up. Me, I will never get out of this darkness. Yeah, thank you. I guess I better go. Uh-huh. So we did it without killing them. And we put 19 speechcraft, but we're gonna need that anyway, so. Quest log updated. Now that I know what happened to the three brothers, it's time to return to Dan and tell him about this difficult situation. See, can we trade with these people? Do they have anything that we need? Let's go see if we can steal something off them as well. Can't meet. Ah, no, we're actually overweight anyway. I really hope we meet some. Could we barter with this guy? Yeah, we can. He has ammo. 64 rubles. Do we have anything heavy we can get rid of? Oh god. 2700 for those. How much do they weigh? 1.5 kilos. this the better gun? Yeah, we have many of these, I think. Or the 7, 5, 4. Now we can unload this one. Oh. God damn it. 69 rubles for 8 of those. They weigh so much. Let's put them there. Trade. Ha. You got paper, we got ammo. So is that it? Is this why we came all the way down here? Is there anything we can explore here?